Good afternoon, Dayville Elementary School, and welcome back to another great broadcast of TNN Tiger News Network. Have a great show for you today. Before we get into the show, let's get over to some lunch.
I think it's time to get some lunch.
Lunch, it's time for lunch.
Lunch,
it's time to munch, crunch, eat a bunch. It's time for lunch, not brunch.
I'm starving.
Lunch,
lunch,
it's time for lunch.
Lunch,
it's time to munch, crunch, eat a bunch. It's time for lunch, not
get
brunch.
Eat some cheese, peas, broccoli, greens, beans.
Tomorrow, Tuesday, October 26, 2021, you guys are going to be having chicken nuggets. That's going to come with a salad, french fries, fruit juice, and of course, your choice of milk. This week, during Red Ribbon Week, every day is a different dress-up day. Today was Protect Your Friends from Drugs. Wear a superhero t-shirt or a red shirt. Saw a lot of you with red on today, so great job protecting your friends from drugs. Tomorrow, October the 26th, Tuesday, is Peace Out to Drugs. Wear peace signs and or a tie-dye shirt. Wednesday, October the 27th, Drugs Can't Find Me. Wear camo. Thursday, October the 28th, Team Up Against Drugs. Wear your t-shirt of your favorite team. And Friday, October the 29th, is Too Smart to Start Drugs. Dress for Success. Friday is also school picture day. So dress for success, come sharp. I want to see some sharp looking people on Friday. So those are the day dress up days for the week. So hopefully everybody comes with dressed up for those days to participate in Red Ribbon Week. I said it. All right, guys, have a great video for you. Let's hit strong on how this week got started. So let's go ahead and get over to the video.
Hello, I'm Badge Man, a demand reduction coordinator and ambassador for the Drug Enforcement Administration. I'm reporting for DEA today on DEA's Red Ribbon campaign, why we celebrate it and how. Red Ribbon is celebrated the last week of October with the wearing of red ribbons by millions of Americans across the country and around the world to symbolize their commitment to make America drug-free. Let's take a look at how Red Ribbon Week began.
Like many hugely positive things, Red Ribbon Week grew out of something profoundly negative. The savage murder of Enrique Kiki Camarena, a Drug Enforcement Administration special agent. On February 7, 1985, life forever changed for the Camarena family. Enrique Kiki Camarena Salazar, loving husband, father, son and brother, decorated Marine, police officer and special agent, had been kidnapped by drug dealers, never to be seen alive again.
He was taken to a house not too far away from the consulate where he was tortured. He was kept alive by injections so he could relay more information about what he knew about the traffickers. And after a few days of torture, he was killed.
For his kidnappers, the story was to end there. However, for his family, friends, and a grateful nation, it was only the beginning. They hunted down, captured, and brought his killers to justice. They pledged to not let his legacy fade and his sacrifice be in vain. His body was flown back to the United States aboard a military plane. It was a sad journey. At his funeral, hundreds of law enforcement officers paid their final respects to a fallen comrade.
Kiki is not the only special agent who has returned home or who will return home on his shield. We shall not fail to honor his trust in us.
Across the country, citizens wore and displayed red ribbons, not only in memory of Special Agent Camarena, but for all those whose lives were lost trying to free the nation from drugs. Beyond that, the red ribbons symbolized the development of an attitude of intolerance regarding the use of drugs. In a 1988 proclamation, Congress established Red Ribbon Week to commemorate the life and work of Kiki and to show intolerance for drugs in our schools, workplaces, and communities.
Over the years, the Red Ribbon campaign has expanded and flourished. Today, the seven-day celebration, supported and encouraged by the Drug Enforcement Administration, can be found in schools and communities across the country. Now, we will hear from DEA Administrator Michelle Linhart.
Although he lost his life in the line of duty more than 25 years ago, DEA Special Agent Kiki Camarena's memory remains alive today because of the millions of people who honor his memory each year through Red Ribbon initiatives and by taking the Red Ribbon Pledge to live drug-free lives. The efforts of DEA special agents like Kiki are men and women in law enforcement, parents, teachers, counselors, and all those who stand on the front lines in the fight against drug abuse should be applauded for their extraordinary work. Protecting our citizens, especially our children, from the tragedies of drug abuse is what Red Ribbon Week is all about. There is no better way to remember Kiki than to recommit ourselves to the drug-free message of the Red Ribbon campaign. Please join me in making the pledge and remembering those who, like Kiki, have made the ultimate sacrifice to keep our country safe from drugs.
As you can see, Red Ribbon isn't about being silent. It is about acknowledging the threat that drugs pose to every community and recognizing that each of us can make a commitment to make ourselves and our communities better places to live. So let's all take the Red Ribbon Pledge and do our part. This year, let's all renew our commitment to stand up, take action, and carry on Kiki's legacy. It's up to us.
Hopefully everyone got some information from that video. We've had this stuff on, but I know over time you kind of forget how this week got started. So hopefully everyone got that information and understands how important it is to stay drug free. Well, that brings us to the end of another great broadcast of TNN Tiger News Network. And as we always say, Tigers travel to the top.